What are generics? So let us learn about the generics. What happens is that when you write a Java program, what do? You plan so much, right? What do? You plan how the program will be, what is the flow of the program, the algorithm of the program, then you program or you execute it or you test. So there are so many steps or number of steps involved to write a program so that a program is free from any error or bugs. But still, if you receive any error or a bug at a compile time, it is easy for you. You can still handle those kind of a error. But if you receive a bug at the runtime, that is at dynamic time when you're running your program, at that time if you receive, it becomes difficult or problematic for you to hold or capture that kind of an error and resolve that error. So generic is a concept which allows you to find at most if there is any error at compile time itself, which will become easy for you to handle. Then why do you use generic? Why don't you use non-generic code? The normal code that we write, why don't you use that? Why is it always recommended to use generic code? What are the advantages of using a generic code over a non-generic code? The main advantage of it is that it will find if there is any error at the compile time, because it becomes easy for you to handle the bugs at compile time than at runtime. The next advantage of it is that the concept of typecasting is removed. It eliminates the concept of typecasting. If you are using the concept of generic, it eliminates the typecasting thing. The third important advantage is that it forces or enforces you to use the concept of algorithm, that you have to follow the algorithm way. But now what is generic? Now we know that why you use generic, what is generic and how it is advantageous over non-generic code. But what is the main utilization or use of generic code? What exactly it does in nature? It says that you create one generic class or one generic method of one particular type and then it can be used of another type. That is, it says that a generic method and class enable programmers to specify within a single method declaration a set of related methods. What do you mean by that? You declare one method, but you can perform set of related methods. That is, for example, if you have written a sort method to sort a number of integers, and then later if you want to sort number or doubles or any float values or string values, what do? You again rewrite the program. So in order to avoid those concepts where you have to rewrite again and again for the same concept, remember the concept is same but the values are different. Once you are sorting the value which are of integer type, next double, then string and all, but the concept is sorting. So generic allows you to write one concept and then keep changing these values. And how do you do that? Let us see that. It says that using this concept, you use the generic sort method. So, and it will allow you to find the error at the compile time. So now we have created a method like generic method test, a class called generic method test, and then we have defined a generic method. Let us pay attention to this, which is a generic method. It says that now the generic method, what kind of a type parameter it is, you need to provide in this angular brackets. What is this type parameter? See, normally what happens is that when you create a method in a class, those methods has certain number of parameters, and these parameters may be of any type, string, integer and all, and will hold the value. But now when you don't know what kind of a value it is going to be, will it be string, will it be integer, double, so and so, in those case it is recommended to pass the parameter as a type parameter. This type parameter is nothing but your this type that you have declared in the angular brackets, and this type parameter is defined before the return type. So you declare here your method, you write the return type is what? Before that, in the angular brackets, you provide any letter that you want. I have just used E, you can use any letter, and then in the brackets you provide what is this particular type. So we have written a program where it will display the integer value, then the character value, and so, but you're not defining what kind of a data type will this particular array of integers will consider. Normally, before when we used to write a method, we used to declare what kind of a value will it receive. Will it receive an integer array, string array, and so. But now, when you do not know what kind of a data type will it receive, it is recommended to use a generic way, right? Similar to this, where you have a generic method, you have certain called generic classes as well. In case of generic method, you are just providing a type parameter. Similarly, in generic classes, you will provide type parameters, that is type classes. You say that this class can access these kind of data types. That is, I write one method where I create T1 and T2. I have created T1. You can create A1, A2, B1, B2, anything. Where I say that my method can accept not only integer, but it will accept a string value also. When you know that your class can accept certain values, you can provide it in a generic way. So I have provided T1 and T2, and then in the main method for the generic class, this generic class, how do you call this generic class? You say that this class will include the string or the integer value. So let us execute these programs in practical to understand how these generic classes work, how you create a generic method, how you create these generic classes with different types of data type, and how it follows.
So in this method, we are trying to use a kind of a generic method to allow at runtime or a dynamic time to take different types of value and then display those values. So we have created a class called generic method test, and then first method that we have defined. What happens in our general way is that when you declare a method or when you define a method to print number of value, you need to pass in its parameter what kind of a value will you be receiving. So what we do is that in the main method, when you create an array of integers, we have created here first array which is of integer type, second array which is of your double type, and third array which is of your character type. Now, if you would want to display each of the elements of these arrays, then you have to create three different methods. That is, you need to create first method for integer type, second method for double type, and third method for character type. To avoid these, or to avoid rewriting of a code, we had come out with the concept of generic method. And how you write a generic method, what a generic method does. A generic method will allow you to pass the values at the runtime irrespective of knowing what kind of a value will it be receiving. Its only purpose would be to display the value irrespective of what kind of a data type it is. So we have first created a method. How do you write a general method? Similarly, you write a generic method. You write the access modifier name. If you want to provide static or not, that is on you. Then the return type, method name, and then the parameter. Similarly, you create a generic method, but additionally there are two steps. That is, before the return type, you need to provide the type parameter. Normally in a method, we say that we are providing the value, whereas in case of generic method, you term the value as type parameter. That is, what kind of a value will you be receiving. This letter is irrespective. Instead of E, you can write any letter that you would want to. But if you are providing here a letter as E, this type parameter should match with the type parameters that you are providing in your method. So you write the access modifier name, static, the type parameter, void keyword, because this particular method is not returning any value, then the method name, and then in the brackets you would create an array, because this array will receive number of elements of these array to display it, right? So if you had to display a normal method, how would you have written is that public static void, because this does not return anything, print array, and then you would have defined array of integers. And that you, how would you have defined? You would have just written one array right? This is how you write, but you need to provide what kind of an array it is. So you would have written array of integers. So now your array name would be array, and this array will hold a value of int type. Similarly, you have written your generic method. If you see the access modifier name, static, the return type, but before the return type, you are providing the type parameter. It means this E can accept any type of value. In the method, then you provide the type, what kind of a value will it be receiving. If you have written here E, it means E. This can hold integer type or string type or double or any type that you provide at the runtime. And then you give your array name, right? So this is simple how you create your method. And in this method, then you are trying to traverse each and every element of an array. If you had to traverse the elements using a normal for enhanced loop, how would you have used? Because this array is holding of integer type, therefore you have to create an array or a variable which holds integer value. So you would have written int element and then colon and then the array name. So this is how you would have been traversing each an element of an array if it is of integer type. So you have written or created one variable of integer type, and then when you traverse through each and every element of array of integers, each and every value will be stored in this. Similarly, you have created an enhanced for loop to traverse through a generic method, right? So you have your array name as input array, and then you created a variable name called element. But this variable is what type, we do not know. We do not know at the compile time. That will be known at the runtime. Therefore, this type parameter should be same, right? And then how do you print the value? You print the value in the printf method or println method, and then you provide what kind of a value or where it has been stored, right? Then in the main method, as we have already seen, we have created three arrays, one of integer, second double and third of the character type. And now you have to call each and every method on this. That is, you have to first print array of integer type. So you call the print array of integer array type. That is, you are providing, you are calling the same method by passing different values at the runtime. You do not have to create separate or different kind of a methods for each of these arrays. So let us execute this program. And now, as you can see, it displays first the integer value, then the double value, and third the character value, right? So this is how you create your generic method. Let us see how you can create your generic class now, okay? So now if you see, you have created a generic class which holds two parameters, that is T1 and T2. What do you mean by this? This is nothing but your type parameter. Let us first see the main method. In this main method, you have instantiated your class with two values. That is, you are trying to say that at the runtime, I would want to provide certain values. One should be of string type, the other should be of integer type. But at the compile time, that were not known. Therefore, you have T1 and T2. And then you are trying to call the display method by providing the value first of string type, second of your integer type, right? So you have created a method called display that accepts two variables. One variable will be of T1 type and second variable will be of T2 type, where you do not know what is this T1 and T2. And then you are trying to display the what kind of this T1 and T2 is, you would only know at the runtime. That is, you have declared now here what is this T1 and T2. One is of string type, the another one is of your integer type. And then you display. So let us execute this. And as you see in the console, it will display the value. The first one it will take as of a string type and the second one it will be integer. If you even want to swap at the runtime, like for an example, we are trying to create, another object reference, first of your integer type and second of your integer type. what happens to this? We need to see that, and then we call out our display method, one of again integer type and second again of integer type. As you can see, when you are writing the values, it says please enter the value of integer var1 and integer var2, because this object to reference holds two values, that is t1 and t2. Again, using this generic class, you do not have to recreate the method again and again. It says that while instantiating the class, please declare what type of data will it receive and then display. So let us execute this program, and now as you see, it says 101 and 101, right? So this is how you create your generic methods and generic classes.